Who are you? I don't mean what's your name. I mean, who are you down deep inside? I bet you've never been asked that question before. You see, when we're born, we don't know who we are. We're given a name, but that's not who we are. So how do we discover our identity, who we are, our self-esteem, our self-image? Well, for most of us, our self-image, our identity, is based on what people say to us and how people treat us. Now, the first people who have the greatest impact on our identity are, of course, our parents. So if they treat us well and with honor and they encourage us and build us up, our identity, our self-esteem grows. But if they're broken themselves and they're nasty and hurtful, our self-esteem shrinks and our identity grows smaller. And then the next people to have an impact on our self-esteem, self-image, our identity are our teachers. If we do well at school and they speak highly of us, we feel built up. But if we do poorly and they speak poorly of us, we feel like losers. And then as we get older, it's our employers, our pastors, our spouse. Anyone who has any authority over us has a big impact on our self-esteem, our self-confidence, and our identity. But the problem with that is that that means that such an important part of us is based on the words and actions of other people. Well, that's a very flimsy foundation for your identity. Because that can go in any different direction depending on how people treat you. Now, when I was growing up, when I was a teenager, my youth pastor came to me and he said, "Grant, have you ever considered going into the ministry?" He saw a pastor in me, because at the time I was picking my post-secondary education. So he saw a pastor in me, but I didn't. So I paid no attention to that. And then in medical school, when I went to my psychiatric rotation, my psychiatric professor said, "Would you consider becoming a psychiatrist? I see potential in you." You see, he saw a psychiatrist in me, but I didn't, so I refused his offer. I wanted to become an anesthetist. And so that's what I did. And so I did that for a few years, but that really didn't fit me. That really didn't suit me. And so God slowly changed my career path, and so now I'm actually a psychiatric minister, which really is very much like what those people saw in me. They were probably right to some extent. But that's not who I am. And you see, as people get older, they often hide behind their occupation. And they say, "Well, I'm a such and such, you know, I'm a doctor, or I'm a teacher." And so they hide behind that and they say, "That's my identity." But that's your role, that's not your identity. And you see, Satan doesn't want you to discover who you really are. Because if you discover your true identity, your true destiny, your gifts, callings, your anointing, that's too scary for him, because you can do him great damage if you know who you really are. But the only person who knows who you really are is Jesus, because he knew you before you were born. He planted gifts in you. There's a calling, there's an anointing, there's potential in you that only he knows about, not the people around you. And so if you really want to know who you are, you need to ask Jesus and let him tell you. But most people don't think of that. They depend on the words and actions of the people around them, which is very, very faulty and a flimsy foundation. So today I want you to ask Jesus, because he is willing to speak to you. He can't wait to tell you. He's been wanting to tell you all these years if you would just ask. So here's how you do it. When this video is over, you turn it off, go to a quiet place, and just be alone with Jesus. And here are three very helpful questions to open that discussion. First, ask him, "Jesus, how do you feel about me?" Because you need to know his feelings towards you. And the second is, "Jesus, would you describe me? Describe my personality, my potential, my destiny, my gifts. Could you describe that to me?" And then the third is, for those of you who are very picture-oriented, "Jesus, could you give me a picture of who I really am? How do I look like to you?" And allow Jesus to put pictures and words into your mind, because that's how you really are. And so now I want to hear from you. I want you to tell me, what did Jesus tell you? What did he show you? And put your comments and your testimony in the box below this video so that we can enjoy what he told you. It'll inspire someone else to be brave enough to ask those questions. And if this is your first visit here, you need to get my free self-assessment guide. And to do that, just subscribe to our weekly email newsletter by filling out the subscription form, which you can get by clicking on the link, "Join the Transformation Movement." And I'll talk to you again next week, but this week, have the courage to ask Jesus who you really are. It will change your life.